we go check the fuselage, we want to see any bends, any damage to the structure, as we have a skin stressed frame with springs and formers inside. We would see a damage on the frame if there would be crumbled skin here. We don't have the chopper. Then we have the leading edge of the elevator. Here we have a little repair because there was a hanger problem. Somebody knocked in the hanger, so we have repaired this one, though that looks okay.
Okay.
Here we have the elevator. The elevator, you can see inside as pulling up. See the controls pull.
Oh, yeah.
We see our connections here. Like all this looks okay. Looks okay. This one we don't want to push because it's connected to the rudder and to the nose wheel, so we will damage. Don't want to do that. We don't push this one. Our hinges, our screws, they're all in. Looks okay. Then we bend down here and we have a look. We want to see that our whole fuselage underneath is straight, so we have no damage. Here we can see the link for the cables. Everything's spun by cable.
Okay.
Under the floorboard to the controls. Link, so we can move the control surfaces. Here we have the trim tab. The trim tab, we should have put on neutral. It's almost neutral for the pre-flight inspection to see that it remains neutral. Again, we check our hinges. Looks all okay. Actuator to pull and push. Again, we want to see that damage from the hanger. Our leading edge, no bird strikes. We want to see our tail section, empennage. Looks okay. We repaired this part. Our fuselage, antenna, flaps, like we had on the other side already. So we look again for linkages, that all those links are in okay condition. We have again our aileron here. We look at connections. And we have the actuator. And again, we put our hands to protect our hand, because if the co-pilot or your other friend moves on the other side,
yeah, and then your finger's cut off.
Your finger 100% will cut off. Mm-hmm. Nice and sharp edges.
Wow.
That will take care of your fingers. And you see pilots with a lot of hours, they walk around like this because
no fingers.
Fingers is lost somewhere in the Okay, here again we look at damages. Could be in the hangar. We look at bird strike. We look at our strut, tires, creep marks, brakes, brake disc, brake assembly.
So whatever we do there, the same.
We do here, yeah. We just walk around, and we walk around anti-clockwise because our left eye has more vision than our right eye. So when you try out and put your hands here, right eye stops here, but left eye, I still see my hand. So it will have an opportunity to catch something and correct it. That's why we always sit on the left side as a pilot, because our left side
can see
better, see more than our right side. So when you try out, just try out, stand over there, put your hand here and look straight, and we'll see our hand stops here somewhere, but our left hand is here, so we have more view from the left.
Yeah.
That's why pilots sit
left. Yeah, oh, no wonder.
One reason.
Yeah.
Okay, now. Windshield clean, we want to be able to see out. Now we come to the engine part. We want to see how much oil we have. How much oil should we have? Okay. Now that's a question depending on the engine. And the answer is in the pilot operating handbook, or it should be written here, or on top here. And it says 8 quarts. So this engine, which is a Lycoming 320 E2D, needs 8 quarts, between 7 and 8. So we had 7, which is okay.
Okay.
Anything below 4 will definitely damage the engine.
Anything below 4?
But we will never go below 4. We will never go at 4. At 7, we must top up and refuel oil to make sure it is...
Is this the same oil as the car oil?
No. This is W100. It's a special oil for aircraft only.
Okay.
Comes from Canada all the way.
Really?
Expensive. So, we close it here, but we should have checked what? Fuel drain. Fuel drain is a little... pull here.
Oh, okay.
But this aircraft, which is a carburetor operated aircraft, we pull and we see the fuel coming out. The fuel that comes out, we could collect, but we don't gonna collect and put it back in because it will have some sediments, as this is the lowest part between aircraft and fuel tank and engine.
Okay.
Yeah, so between fuel tank, engine, this is the lowest part, all dirt will be captured there. We come to the front, we look at our cowling being all put in together, we check our exhaust, we don't want to touch it because if it's hot then we burn our hands.
Yeah.
If it's not attached, we can't fly, there's no power to the engine. Here we have our propeller, we want to see our trailing edge, our leading edge. Then if you touch your hand here, not only will you get dirty, but you can feel it's very rough.
Yes, yes.
So, where does the roughness come from?
Stones and chips of...
Stones, chips, rain.
Oh.
And even the wind will wear out the propeller. So the propeller doesn't last forever. The propeller lasts, like the engine, 2,000 hours. Then needs to be overhauled or purchased a new one.
2,000 hours, yeah. Okay.
We look inside. We can have a check at the 172 at our
belt.
Yeah. That will run the alternator.
Okay.
Then we want to see if there are any birds in there. Birds love to go and nest in here.
Mm.
Yeah. Then we check our nose strut. We want to have about four fingers.
Okay.
Four fingers?
Yeah. Okay. Because we just pulled it out. Oops. Okay, four fingers. We want to have the right suspension. If it's too strong, it is in hydraulic fluid and air pressure, the nose wheel will be too far extended and on landing will shake. If it's too low, it will shake. It's got to have the right pressure in order to make a proper landing.
Okay.
We go toward this side of the aircraft. Air intake for our vacuum.
Okay.
Static
pressure.
Inlet is here. That is the hole why many planes have crashed. Because engineers or people clean the plane, put a tape on it so not to allow water to come in, but before flight
they forgot to take it out.
The pilot forgot to check and remove the tape. So what is the result if this is taped up?
So static pressure for the
airspeed,
altitude indicator, and HSI.
HSI.
Okay. Oh. And vertical. VSI is using pitot, right?
Yeah. Well, you know, here's the pitot,
yeah,
which we're going to talk about now. But here we will, because of the density pressure on the ground being much higher than in the sky, we will have a misreading as we climb.
Okay.
And the question is now, will with density what we have now, which is like 1012, what will the airspeed be if we close it up at 10,000 feet? Will it be higher or will it be lower? Indicating on the ASI.
It will be higher.
Okay. We leave this answer to everybody to check,
yeah,
on squawk. Aircraft, there is a question inside. Will it be higher? Will
or
it be
lower? Okay.
We need to see it. But because of that, a lot of planes crashed already. The most famous one or infamous one was the Air France flying to Brazil. Somehow was closed. Died.
Okay.
Yeah. We go towards here. We look at our leading edge. We see our pitot cover. We remove this pitot cover, and after each flight, this pitot cover should be put on. That little hole, again, very attractive for flying insects to go in, build a house, and blocking our tube. This is a pitot tube, and it will supply information for airspeed. It has some more holes, more on ground class. Pre-flight, we just want to see it's okay, it looks okay, and it doesn't look damaged. We go over here. Here we have the stall warning horn. This aircraft has a horn. Some have a vane. So each aircraft has something different. We look in the pilot operating handbook, how to test it. This aircraft, we suck and hear that noise. And that noise will be the stall horn warning.
Okay. You suck or you blow?
I suck.
Okay. Okay.
Blow?
Nothing.
Nothing. You wanna suck?
Yeah, okay.
So, this will indicate what?
Angle of attack.
That's right. It won't indicate our airspeed. It will indicate the angle of attack is coming to the performance envelope where the wing will stall. So okay. What can we do when we fly? We put in power, lower our nose in order to have a lifting surface over the wing, picking us up and giving us lift. More when we fly. We look through the leading edge here. All done. We have completed the pre-flight check. Now what we should do, we check ourselves. We check hungry, thirsty. How many beers did we have last night? If we had, if not, did we have stress? Are we on medication? What other things that could impair us from flying? Driving a car, we can do. But flying a plane is a little bit more tricky because once you're up there, we can't stop and...
You can't stop a sight.
We can't stop a sight.
Buy some for makan.
Buy some makan or go to the toilet.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
Before flight, always make a point, go toilet first. You don't get surprised while you fly because having to go for a pee while you're about to land is a real disaster. And it's very messy.
Okay.
Okay?
Yeah.
So, I go for a pee because my brain already like that. I
see
the plane, I have to pee.
Okay.
And then we get in and start.
Right.
President, you want to pee? Yeah. Man, can you ever?
I'm okay.
Are you okay?
Yeah. There you go, guys. Okay, so we have done our pre-flight check. We are on the November aircraft today, Adventure. Captain Andres has just finished showing us the 360 checks. So we'll wait for them to go in to the toilets, and then we will start our journey for our joy flight. All right, see you guys in a bit.
Okay, here comes the test question. What are we going to do now? Going to fly?
Yes.
How long is our flight?
Well, we booked for an hour.
Yeah.
Okay.
Endurance is 4 hours.
How do we know?
Because you called just now when you say endurance 4 hours.
Is it verified 4 hours?
It is not.
Okay,
that means
so
you have to check.
What shall we do?
You have to check the fuel.
That's right. That is what we have to do before we start. Check the fuel because now we could call the bowser. And
so 360 is not, the checking of fuel is not part of 360?
Sorry?
The checking of fuel is not part of 360?
Yeah, sure.
It is, yeah? Yeah.
And I wanted just to have a warning from you. Hey, how about the fuel? We don't check. Didn't come. Here is our USB port. Memory stick.
Okay.
It has two sides. It has the shaft. It has all those grooves, which are different programs. This one always touch and go landings, and we have other ones for different purposes.
Okay.
And here at the bottom is when you get screwed
from the captain.
Because
because he didn't check the fuel.
That's right. So now these grooves are also, by the way, show us how much fuel is in the tank. So we stick this one in the tank. You need a ladder, except me.
It's
stick it in.
You're tall, Captain.
And we see where it's wet. So that's the real. It's wet at 16. So what does 16 mean?
16 gallons?
16 gallons. Okay. What gallons? US gallons? British gallons?
I guess US gallons, because US aircraft?
US aircraft should be US gallons, but what do? We check the pilot operating handbook. Paramount to everything. Overriding everybody, including this instructor, is the pilot operating handbook.
Okay.
Everything about this aircraft is in there. If there is a change of engine or an attachment, the pilot operating handbook has to be upgraded and has to be approved by whoever's the authority in our case, CAM.
Yeah.
So we have 16 US gallons, one tank. In the other tank, how much is in there?
Supposed to be 16 as well.
But
we don't assume.
Assume, we check. How, what could it be that one tank is empty and one tank is full?
Because the fuel selector is not set properly.
The fuel selector is set on off, or set on left or on right.
On
but
left.
In our case...
Right, sorry. Because right is less than...
16 also.
16 both. Also, yeah. Okay.
So I checked earlier now, it's select on both. So
okay.
Cessna is quite clever. They have both left, right, off. Other aircraft is left, right, off. So we have to really check.
So why would you want to select left or right instead of both?
To balance the wings and the weight.
Oh, okay.
Yeah?
Okay.
Okay, so we have 16. 16 times 2 is 32.
32 gallons
per hour we burn.
5.5 gallons. US gallons.
Pilot training handbook says what?
I don't know. I've not checked. Yeah.
So we make it easy. It's 40 gallons the plane. We can fly 5 hours, so we just say it's 8 gallons per hour.
8 gallons per hour.
Yeah? So with 216 plus 16, 32 is how many hours we can fly? 4 times 8?
32.
So 4 hours endurance.
Simple math.
Simple.
That's the reason why I'm recording this, so I can remember.
Don't make complicate, right? Mm. This whole thing is not about going to details now. We have 4 hours in fuel endurance. How long's our flight? It's half an hour. But what else do we have to consider? In case the airport is closed. When will the airport be closed? Bad weather. Mm-hmm. Highly unlikely. And what else could be? It's a plane crash.
Mm. Mm.
Plane stuck on the runway. Did it happen? Happens a few times already to me. Charlie 130 comes in, lands, hydraulic broken. That whole thing standing on the runway. Holding, supposed to tow, rain is coming, cannot come, cannot tow because raining, we don't work. I ended up in Kapar, Kuala Selangor, and had to fly to Sitiawan. Made the emergency landing Sitiawan because we're running out of fuel, because we're holding 3 hours coming from Singapore. Land in Sitiawan, call my friend, ask him to ferry the fuel to the airport. Rain started, grass wasn't cut, so it was a 3 days delay by getting out of Sitiawan.
So must always have reserve fuel, yeah?
Must have reserve fuel. So what is the fuel reserve? From A to B, our flight plan, plus alternative, plus 45 minutes cruise. US minimum. Ready?
Yes.
Enough talking. Flying. Okay, Capitan, you please sit on here.
Is it?
Okay, left foot, just walk in.
Maybe he wants to go in first?
No. Pilot first. The passengers, we check their boarding pass first, you know. left foot here, let's walk in. Okay, now, you move your seat forward, there's a bar. Move forward so you can put your feet on the rudders. Okay. That's a bit tight. Move a little bit back and then put your seat back on. Okay? Oh yeah, you can go in on it because you have to go back.
Okay.
Yeah? Seatbelt you need, yeah. This one. Okay, put on your headset. First time we fly, right? Okay. So, behind is clear. We can start up. We do our startup proof we have already. Fuel on both, mixture rich, carburetor heat cold, beacon on. Friction throttle nut open. 1, 2, 3. Master on. Flip, flip. Shout out. Watch out after that. Oil pressure is up. And alternator off. Discharging on and charging.
Okay.
Now we put the radio on. We don't want to put the radio on earlier because we will damage the system because of to land, but not too low to let the engine stop. 600.
Okay, number two sky for takeoff.
It's a little bit taking off on runway speed.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Nice? Perfect. I just rolled down the gap and we stopped here.
Parking brake off?
No need parking brake. Okay. Off, off, off. Headset off. We have concluded your first flight.
Excellent. That's awesome. Does it affect the weather? It does.
Yeah, it does. Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, that was amazing, Captain. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Yeah. Four bags.
Two, two. Four.
Seriously, it's fun.
9-1. First flight from WMSA to WMSA. AJW sign 3581. My license 08. We inspected the aircraft this morning and today's flight is 4th of October. October 19. Okay, so from 6 to 1 is 0.5. So half an hour exactly. Nil defects sign. I was the pilot. Flight case closed.
That's it. And this always remains in the aircraft. Okay.
We keep this one until the aircraft has been destroyed plus 6 years.
Wow.
So, they may come back and say, well, let's have a look at your flight on the 15th of February 1976. One moment.
Wow. So who has to keep this? You?
The engineer.
Engineer will have to keep. So if an engineer resigns or goes away or whatever.
Oh, has to pass on the books. No?
It's very important, yeah?
Without it, we can't get an aircraft registered. Okay. I threw one aircraft away already because one book was missing from 1975 to 1978, you know.
That's amazing. Thank you, Gavin. So that's it, guys. We had a good 1 hour fun flight. Well, the idea of this flight is supposed to show us how things work. So Safwan and I will know exactly what to do when we are in ground school, right? So Safwan, join us.
It was awesome, guys.
Yeah?
It was awesome. You guys should try it.
Okay.
Air Adventure Flying Club only at Subang.com.
Okay, so we had fun. So we'll catch you guys later.
Kecil perut lah.
Kecil perut. Cheers. Bye. Okay, now so we are going into Air Adventure office to pick up our t-shirts. Oh, there we go. So this is the place. So these guys are all PPL holders?
Ah, all different, right? So yeah, he just went solo on this picture. It was a drinking night. It's very nice, you know?
Yeah.
If we had a hangout talk, I used to have this aircraft, so with that we sprayed it.
But that's a, is that a...
Anton of two.
Is that a de Havilland Beaver?
No, no, no.
No.
That's bigger. It's okay. Antonov.
Oh, Antonov.
Yeah.
Wow.
Then he got solo, as you can see, he's kissing the ground. Mm. There we did this just now, a steady picture. This is the Land Rover's park over there, used to have zebras.
Yeah.
But no more. Going outing, two planes.
Oh, this is nice.
Yeah, so we're flying two sweet planes together.
Combined, right?
Yeah.
Combined.
Yeah.
There's a Land Rover before paint, you know, that's until again. Yeah, you know, so on snow, he had ground crash. Then gone solo. He's in the United States behind the Air Force.
Yeah.
Somebody got married, Chow, Hidayah. He lives in Ho Chi Minh City, comes to fly. Obviously gone solo, kissing the...
Kissing or sucking?
He's sucking, you know. He said, I don't want to kiss, I'm going to suck. So, Dante and the whole lot. Siri Tien. This is a lawyer and a student, yeah.
Oh.
This was back in Bay 40, right?
Bay 40, yeah.
It's on the other side.
And then, here, what do you want here? Got some Segamat. We made a movie here.
Nice.
This is our president, this is Dore. It's a good friend of mine, and he fly the MiG-21 in the East German Air Force. Gone solo, that's Fahim. He's the designer of our Squawk website. Oh. He's doing that.
Okay.
So he's now in Bucharest, you know. Very funny. Half the team is sitting in Pakistan, the other one sitting in Bucharest, I sitting here, you know. This is but it works, you know. Oh, that's all. What about flying? Oh. That's the Antonov again.
Yeah. What's happened to the Antonov? It's gone?
Oh, it's gone, yeah.
Really?
Yeah. Oh, somebody cut it up and threw it away, you know.
Oh, shit.
So obviously I will not talk with this guy anymore. It was, we went on a flight, yeah. It was nice. It's a BFM radio, jazz guy.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Nice.
Here you can see the flight, everybody, no? Just married.
Honeymoon flight.
Honeymoon flight, yeah. So she was complaining to him. What's the problem with her? She wants to fly.
Oh, okay.
Okay, let her fly. Are you sure? You think she can do it? Of course, she goes in. She was that good. It's the TB20 in the hangar. That's me, many years ago.
Really?
Oh, wee.
Wow. That, what, where is that?
That's it. That's
Subang.
Bay 40. Yeah, Bay
40. Wow.
It's my son, me, in Pankow.
Oh, nice.
That's me, gone solo. Also gone solo. And over there is special flying skills, you know. This wall, you know. We only teach witches on drones. So she went around, come back. Not too long the flight, you know, but quite good, you know. Then we had a
special flying skills.
Engine failure.
What happened to the Tango Fight Charlie?
Yeah, yeah. Chow had engine failure next to Sungai Besi. So emergency land over there. Then took the, everything apart, bring it here.
Oh, okay.
Repair the engine. That's Mutalib on the Antonov.
Uh-huh.
Over there we did emergency landing.
Okay. Also the
palm oil.
With so that was that's it. Now we're heading back to the terminal so we can go home. And I'm some roti canai and teh tarik.
So we race first the ATR.
Let's race with the ATR.
And the winner is, we are gaining speed, we're gaining speed. Ready for takeoff.
Eyes on the road, Captain.